John.
It's on.
Hey!
Hi!
Hey. Hello!
Welcome to Black Bag Vikings. Thank you very much for joining us. We are all completely ready to run tonight.
Dom did not just sabotage us.
Dom didn't just say, all right, everyone, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! We appreciate you being here. Last time, we had everybody together for the first episode. The Jarl's son was mysteriously murdered. And his corpse was taken way off into the woods and put up a tree.
We can't prove he was murdered.
Okay.
It could have been suicide.
He may have dismembered himself.
He dismembered himself with the accuracy of a modern surgeon.
While being thrown from a catapult into a tree.
Yes.
Vikings were that good.
Maybe he just had really weak skin and it just kind of came apart really easily.
That's an unfortunate condition.
Yes.
Got weak skin.
He was the Vikings. His name was Frankenstein's son.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
yeah. Of course.
Yeah. So he was sewn together anyway.
Frankenstein.
Frankenstein.
Frankenstein's son.
Anyways, you were recapping for everyone before we really interrupted you.
So you guys went out, you searched for him. You got waylaid by a bunch of Vikings that you figure are spies who are checking out the town, Stavangard, here is the map if you want to take a look at it. Dom has the map on
I
the
will look
computer.
At it. John, oh my gosh.
Fine, I didn't want to look at it anyway.
Really?
I've already seen it.
No. This is shocking.
So, you guys, nowhere near as good as the cutouts that you did for your show on this adventure. That was ridiculous.
Sometimes you just have to set a standard and know that no one else can meet it.
I know. I'm doing woodworking now. It won't be in the show for 4 or 5 weeks, but I'm building a small cottage of things and, you know.
Oh, cool.
And then I won't be able to match that.
And then we'll go back and forth, so you'll be doing
an ending competition
after a while.
You'll just build a whole set, and it'll be like, today it's going to be live action, so.
So we're just LARPing.
Here's my set.
I'm getting on the blacksmith.
Exactly. But listen, players, you can only your characters can only travel within this 6 square foot area.
Really, everything happens here.
Right,
it's
here.
A locked room mystery.
What does this room look like? What does this room look like?
Like this.
You get the point.
Have you guys ever seen that movie? What is it called? The Cube.
No. I can't watch The Cube.
No, it's.
Is that Cube?
What?
You're talking about, or I think it's just called Cube.
Cube?
I'm thinking of Cube.
You know what I'm talking about?
He's,
yes. Yeah.
Where they built the one set and then just used it over and over again?
That's the one where the people are like trapped inside the thing and they like have
it's
to.
It's like a maze cube, but every room looks the same.
Yeah.
The one movie that I want to see that I've only seen the trailer on YouTube like a couple of years ago is Chopping Mall.
What?
Yes, Chopping Mall. A group of young kids who are in their 30s get trapped in a mall with robots that are trying to kill them.
Oh, that sounds awesome.
As a security, it's called, I never heard of it before, it's called Chopping Mall.
Oh man, I have a new Two Penny Theater then. I'll track it down and I'll host it. Over at the house, in the backyard, on the screen.
Yeah, because it looks horrible, but wonderful at the same time. They went out and they got attacked. You guys figured that these were spies looking at the best way to attack, invade the city. And you killed them all except for a couple got away. Two of them ran away. You were also attacked by a bear. The bear almost killed Mangus.
Briefly killed him.
Briefly.
Really did,
very briefly killed him.
Which, by
before
the way, to clarify,
erotically brought him back
there are no negatives.
I forgot about
that. Wait, erotically?
Ben had a whole erotic Viking.
He got so big.
It was like, And it was special.
Good times.
Anyway, and the funny thing is that they revived him, like, during this whole scene, he keeps going and going. So I say, okay, you're revived. He's like, what? I'm like, that's the way it works. You never get to finish. You're done. Let's go. But wait. Ben ate a heart, a human heart, and
a bear heart.
A bear heart. So there was that. And then you guys go back. And a couple of things. First of all, damage is at zero. Once you hit zero, you go unconscious, and then you have to make a death save, basically, against your constitution. So I
do want to apologize to Chat 2 weeks ago when I brought him down into negative numbers because it totally jacked how everybody was donating to bring Ben up. So we did add some
he's got some bonus. Yeah, yeah. And we do appreciate all of the donations you guys do. It definitely helps out with the show. One of the cool things that the donations do is we are wearing upgraded mics right now.
Ooh.
Fancy. I'm sorry. Ooh.
Now we're wearing blown out. Thanks, man.
Yeah.
And the donations is what helps us be able to do those kind of things. So thank you. All right, so without further ado, we're going to jump into things and then, because I've been chatting too much as it is.
Should we not introduce our guest players?
Well, I was going to do that, yes.
Oh, I thought you were jumping in and introducing people. I see.
So let's start with you. Introduce yourself, Talene.
I will. Hi, everybody. I'm Talene. And I'm here tonight playing Sorsha Cusack, an Irish nun. Wait, should I have told everyone that? Should that be a secret?
No.
It's a secret.
It's not just a secret
nobody.
Anymore.
Shh.
Don't tell anyone.
Literally tens of people know your secret now.
No!
Go ahead.
Probably as high as dozens.
Is your
tens
mom Bath Morda?
What?
Is your mom Bath Morda?
In Fear, there's this album.
But that one, that's an awesome movie. I love that movie.
It's a good movie.
Anyway.
Howdy, folks. I am Nick Levy, and I am playing Bragi Helgason, who is a Skald. It's a, for those of you who are not versed in Viking lore, it is people who are the orators, the oral storytellers, the historians, and later on, depending on what historical period, in, also the lawgivers.
Mm-hmm. You guys are in it's like 1827. So I mean 827. So you're
like 1827 was gonna really screw me up.
It's like forever ago.
It's forever ago. And you're pretty early, is what I'm saying. It's before a lot of Christian missionaries showed up and all that. So.
Okay.
So we're gonna start the evening.
You're committed to your character.
Yeah.
All right. I want to make sure I don't. Too loud?
Let's see if I can get into the leather and make you a patch.
First, do your blacksmith thing.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on.
Because I want the
one. I have a job.
You have a job. I don't think you need to get that. You've had a rough day.
I have.
You have.
I really have.
Had a rough day. You were part of a nunnery. You guys, what kind of things do you do at your order? Like, what things do you do?
Well, we are an order of nuns committed to praying and seeking visions and reaching out to the Lord for true inspiration, connection across the veil. My nunnery was on the coast, like built high, really stone. We get hit by the Vikings all the freaking time. Those dang Vikings are too lazy to go inland. They just always come and take our stuff. We're like, Ireland is like the Viking ATM. They're coming in, taking our stuff, going off again.
I've read that.
You have,
yeah.
Of course you have, because it's the truth.
Okay, so.
And we collect holy relics to help us reach the other side. We collect these holy relics and then these heathen Vikings come, take them, melt them down for gold and bring curses and the hatred of the Lord upon their heads, which never seems to translate into instant death.
So what's your most important relic that you have?
Well, our most important relic was we had the finger of Saint Balthazar, which bore his ring even.
So it was just a finger with a ring on it?
Yes, but like an old desiccated ring. A little bit of flesh, that's very important, because then it's like, oh, he's not ratting and dying, he's very holy.
And you came up with this independently of anything related to Black Bag, right?
I came up with this independently of anything related to Black Bag.
Interesting. So a ring with a finger. I'm sorry, a finger with a ring on it.
Now, how we kept it?
Strike that, reverse it.
You're terrible at Easter eggs. Can I just everyone, here's an Easter egg. This isn't like anything else that we've done, right? You do that all. Go ahead. Terrible at Easter eggs.
Now, what we had done with St. Balthazar's finger was that we had constructed a shrine for him that was a recreation of all of his body out of gold and gems. And just his one finger was there. And then we kept it in a case of glass, and once a year on his saint's day, we would take it out and parade it through the village so that people could come and put their hand on the glass and receive healing and visions. And what do you think happens when you have something nice like that, huh?
Someone steals it.
Someone comes and steals it. Some nasty freaking Vikings come charging up the side of the bluff. And they come in and they're slashing people down and burning things and taking our stuff. And they took.
If you can't defend it, is it really yours?
they tried. Good what point. They did is they picked up the relic of St. Balthazar, and I, a true Christian and ready for martyrdom, jumped upon the case and said, "Bring it, bitches. You're not taking this. The Lord said, the Lord saith unto thee, stop." They didn't listen. They just carried me with it.
And that is where we're picking up.
Yes.
Okay. So, Dom, I can't find the screen I'm supposed to be on. I apologize. I've been sitting here trying desperately to figure out.
You're giving her as much time as she needs.
As I'm trying to fucking...
Technology, the answer to and cause of so many of our daily problems.
No, when she told
us... Can you describe that, body that you got built in great detail?
Yeah. What, yes. You, like, what we did was...
Keep it going.
We took a...
All right. No, I'm good.
No, we're done.
You're good.
I'm good.
So this is the right screen?
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right, so.
Touch it every now and then or it'll turn off on you.
I know. And then that's I'm hosed. All right, so they attacked in the middle of this horrible storm, which is.
So like them.
It's actually probably 3 o'clock in the afternoon, but the sun's been blacked out by horrible clouds and thunder. And they've. As they were rushing into the nunnery and bashing things about and grabbing people, they started coming towards your room. You kept your relic inside the room, right? Mm-hmm. And because you were studying it, looking at it, trying to figure it out.
I had achieved a special place in the nunnery where I got to sleep in the room with the relic in order to allow it to enter into my dreams, where visions might happen.
As she's eating a lot of rye bread. So.
Real moldy rye bread, real damp, it's real damp.
But it's the finger.
Also, we don't have a guide to when we choose mushrooms. We just take whatever's out there and eat it.
Yeah. It's the only way to be sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So you hear them coming down the hallways, busting into doors, busting down doors and all this. And you know they're going to be in your room any second. And there's that ancient gold ring with the markings on the side, with the perfectly preserved finger. I mean, it looks old, but it's still, relatively well preserved.
Looks good for its age.
What do you want to do with it?
Well, I know from past visits of the, I swallow it. It's the only way to save it.
So you swallow this ring.
I swallow it and the finger.
All whole.
All together.
Does it go down easy?
No, it does not.
Does not.
But I pray I pray as I take it down.
It is not a good feeling.
It's not good. There's a lot of gagging. But I have
The fingernails are surprisingly, the fingernail is surprisingly sharp.
It really, that hung together well.
No.
So there is that issue.
There's a lot of this.
Working it down.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to be all right.
Fuck, he's bursting through the door.
1 second. So you swallow it.
Yes.
And they break down the door and mm-hmm. they grab you by the back of the head and just pull you out.
Yeah, they do. And the reason that they do this, ladies and gentlemen, is because as they enter the room, instead of just saying, there was nothing here, I say, you heathen scoundrels, I swallowed it.
Well, I'm not that frightened. I think it would be more like, you heathen scoundrels, yeah, yeah. I swallowed it.
Yeah, yeah, just like that. Does anyone have any water?
They don't have any water. What's
washer? No, water. So they grab you, they pull you out. They've grabbed about, they usually don't grab as many nuns as they are this time, but this time they've grabbed about 10 of you.
It's a special occasion.
One of you, okay. Oh, where's my little Dom? Oh, here.
Also, we have five of those from last time.
Oh, okay.
I have a note that we have five pushes for the table.
All right, so
I'll just grab those.
Okay, cool. Nick.
For everybody.
Nick. You put Nick. Nick isn't in here anymore.
You mean Broggy?
Broggy?
Broggy Helgeson?
You will only address him as Broggy.
Oh, Nick,
Dom.
I was thinking the character. I'm sorry. Because yeah. You were Nick for so long.
Well, it was. Right. Very
it was always confusing me as well.
That's totally made my brain completely. I'm getting older now.
Nick is Daniel Day-Lewis-ing this whole thing. I will address him as Broggy.
Broggy.
I'm like, Nick, oh shit. Because you two are never in the same room. Wait a minute.
The singularity! We're the same person.
Whoosh. We look so goddamn the same.
Okay, you get three pushes.
Wow.
So for the new people, in this game, you can push.
Right.
Now, if you fail a roll, you can use your push. If you fail the push, something bad happens. So it's kind of, it's one of those, should I do this or not?
And you cannot push a push.
Can't push push.
I wouldn't want to.
And who are these from?
Because I like Newtonian
these
physics.
These are from BSB Care. Thank you very much.
Thank you, BSB Care. Thank
you're
you. Woo.
You're a nice man.
Yes. You are, sir. So they're dragging you down the hallway. They, you get out in this horrible storm, and there's all these flashes. And every once in a while when a flash happens, there's this, like, weird glow, kind of this yellow green glow way off into the distance, and you see the waves kind of come up, and you can swear something's out there, and it's disturbing to look at. It makes you uncomfortable, so you kind of close your eyes a little bit, and they throw you onto the boat. Now there's this woman that recently came to the nunnery. She's probably 7 months pregnant, and she was looking for sanctuary, because she had nowhere else to go. And you guys were going to help her have the child and then, hopefully she would, either join and raise the child at the nunnery or do adoption or whatever, whatever would work best. She's there with you. You guys are pushed to the back of the boat and you're in the waves, you're going up and down.
I hope I don't throw up and lose my holy relic.
Yes.
How embarrassing that would be.
That's pretty terrible.
She swallowed a finger. Holy God. So the waves are going and there's this horrible wind's happening. And this woman is just crying. And she goes, sister, come here, please.
And I'm here for you. Oh, Lord. The Lord looks over you and you're suffering.
No,
you don't understand. I don't.
This storm is my fault. I can't have this child. You have to kill me. I can't get. She starts yelling.
She's yelling this?
Yeah, she starts. No, she starts.
Oh, she's
yelling.
Like yelling in pain.
Yeah, and she's way. It's way too early for her to have contractions.
Okay.
And she's like, you can't let this baby come into the world. And the boat's going up and down. And the men don't seem to, like, be looking back at you guys at all. They're mainly trying to, keep the ship going. Why they left in this storm, you don't understand why Vikings would ever
But why would I understand Vikings? My mind is not so evil as that.
Yes, very true.
Now, you're a Catholic nun, right?
Yes.
Not one of those Baptist nuns I hear so much about.
No, not one of those Baptist nuns.
Only the 1800s Vikings know about the Baptist
right,
nuns.
Right, that's true.
Am I laying down my Catholic wrong? Because...
No, I'm like, you're in quite a moral quandary right here.
Here's the problem. Is it that moral of a quandary? Because these notaries are full of baby bones.
Mm. Yeah, very true.
I've probably seen a lot of babies be killed.
She's probably not asking you to kill the baby. She's asking you to kill her.
That's a little
and
tougher.
Murder is a mortal
and
sin.
I don't have anything to murder her with.
I left my murdering stick at home. It's in my other bag.
Okay, so I'm obviously going to go that other route. This is hard. I'm having to change my mind very deeply to do good things.
It is hard. Yes. Whew.
Gnome. Sister. Every life is valuable. God, don't make no mistakes.
No, you don't understand. God had nothing to do with this child. The father... He was very evil, and we can't let this baby come into the world. I was gonna kill myself, but I was kind of hoping the Vikings would have killed me, but death by Viking is a very good way to go, but it just didn't happen. And now here we are in the middle of the sea.
You know that if you kill yourself, young lady, you cannot enter heaven.
That's why you
And if your child dies without baptism, he'll go to purgatory forever. See, I'm pulling it out.
Yes,
I know some Catholic things.
No, you're nailing it.
I've been married to a Catholic for 18 years. I'll let you know whatever you need to know.
Thank you.
All right. So she goes, look, it's more important than that. And then she passes out. And you're kind of looking at her like...
I'm cradling her head because I'm a nun. I'm very good. I'm comforting her and I'm like...
Okay.
I don't know, patting her forehead, what kind of medicine?
You know, like,
uncomfortable stuff. Yeah. Nun stuff. Okay.
Should be fine.
Should be fine. All right, so the boat is jostling quite hard, and these guys are trying to keep, you know, from going over, and water is splashing on. And it's pretty much open, right? Every once in a while, you see these flashes, these yellow, weird flashes.
That doesn't look good.
And suddenly, you guys get hit on the side by this really big wave, and it kind of tosses you up. Make a con check for me. As you're holding her.
First check of the night.
What do I roll?
D100.
Bum, 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 bum.
You want to roll low.
I want to roll low.
Under your con.
Roll low.
That is not right. Low. It's incorrect.
You told your dice to do the right thing, but they didn't listen.
These are my ugly dice. They always roll high. I need to get pretty dice.
Yeah, you want your.
So you failed your con roll.
I totally did. Dice. 97.
All right. Ooh. So you get hit really hard, and that finger was not sitting well.
Oh jeez.
Oh, no.
And. One of the Vikings kind of looks back at you, right, and you're holding this woman. Just, it's okay, dears.
No,
and
my finger
comes shooting out, right?
No, my finger.
And the Viking's like, wait a minute, and runs over, and she wasn't lying. She swallowed a finger, and he grabs the finger, and takes the ring, and takes the ring off. And just hucks the finger back at you.
Oh, back at me? Okay.
And it hits you. And then as soon as it hits you, it decays really fast. And then just turns into dust and disappears into the wind.
Eat the dust.
The dust is gone.
Sniff it like cocaine.
All the fingers dust in the
wind. So
do these Vikings speak...
I wouldn't be speaking Gaelic.
Gaelic.
I doubt it. The Vikings. Mm.
That is a good point. They probably don't speak Gaelic. They might know a few words because she did say that they have been raiding the area for a while.
Frequently.
So, and they do pick up on things like that. Okay, cool.
They got really used to the phrase, I ate it, asshole. So they know what that means.
Right, absolutely. That's, they have a, they're like, I ate it. But no, they only have carved things, so it's I ate it. Ate it. Takes a really long time.
Yeah. Those phrase books are not portable.
No, they're not.
But he was looking back at you. You throw up. A finger comes shooting out with the gold ring.
Yeah.
And so he walks over, takes it. And then she suddenly wakes up, and she's now got vomit on her.
My vomit?
Yep.
Damn it.
And she's like...
I'm going to tell her it's hers.
Coincidentally, someone else's.
But also...
She goes, did I throw up?
Well.
No. No, sweetheart. Lord. Listen, this is very serious. I just lost a holy relic. So I need to be like...
We're laughing with
I'm
you.
I'm really upset. Hang on, let me get really upset.
She's really upset.
I can't do it because you're all looking at me.
Well, look over here.
Yeah, everyone look at each other.
No!
You know that's what happens with actors, right?
I know.
People look at you.
I know.
We're not actors.
No!
We're playing a game.
No! No, St. Balthasar, I have let you down. Oh, curse me, God. Let the earth swallow me up. The ocean eat me. There's nothing left. I'm useless. I have failed at the one thing I needed to do. Don't worry about it. The vomit isn't yours. That was good acting right there.
She let her wait so long before you told her whose vomit.
No, it was very important.
She was like, cool, but did I throw up or?
I lost a holy relic. Come on, people.
This poor woman.
I don't know her that well. I've been with the relic for years.
You're right, she's an asshole.
She's saying crazy stuff about her baby.
She is.
Look, you've got to do this for me. Just get something, and there's got to be a blade around here somewhere or something. Please, it's important.
There's a blade around here, but I won't be using it on you, my friend. And I go up to the guy who stole the ring that I vomited.
Go ahead.
And I steal his knife.
Give me a dex roll, what the hell?
Really big, acts like
a... Oh, and before you do this, because you might need these.
Oh, God.
Oh, geez, okay. Ooh. Thank you, everyone, I really appreciate it. Thank you for donating. Cool.
Fan favorite to me.
No.
Acting!
So is that Razlak? Razlak? Am I saying that right?
Guys.
Razlak gives you 3 pushes.
Thank you! Thank you, Razlak.
Just so I remember, the Bard 1971 gives you your glory.
Oh.
Okay, your
my pro.
Your pro. Ooh. You from Christian get Linky get 1 push.
Thank you very much, Christian.
And you had 3 already that were table that you put out there.
No, there are 5 for
5
the table.
Table. Okay, cool.
Who did you say about mine, the Bard?
Bard 1971,
I believe. Thank you, the Bard.
All right, so you're going to try to steal this guy's knife off of him.
I am. Knife. I'm stealing that knife. Now, I'm not right trying.
Just so you
I'm
know, doing. Right as you're about to steal his knife, you notice on his neck some weird, like, line down this side, and it just moves barely and then shuts.
What the hell is happening on this ship?
Nice. Wait, it shuts?
Yeah.
It was open?
It opens line, just you know. Opens and shuts.
Okay. Was I supposed to do under my decks?
Always under.
Yes.
Well, nope.
You can push it.
I'm pushing it.
If you push but it and something goes bad,
yeah.
it goes really bad.
Yeah.
You can only do this once.
What's your dex?
Per roll.
Hang on a
second. Per roll and per push tokens you have.
Do I have other dice that are prettier? My dex is 35.
Ooh, that's good.
I love how the look of your dice are the whether or not they're more random or not.
Oh, everything's rolling good.
Oh my gosh, I'm too successful. And I drained all my dice to roll high numbers. Guys, you. Thanks a lot, D&D.
I'm pushing it. I'm pushing.
Push it real good.
Two.
No.
I hate all of my dice.
Okay.
That was
all
not.
Right. So you startle him as you kind of trip a little bit, and grab onto the
blade.
It does
make sense.
Okay?
Yeah.
And he turns around, and he takes in this big breath, and these two gills along his neck kind of open up as he's shocked, and he hits you.
Okay. Fair enough.
First, make a sand check, so you're rolling against your sanity. You want under. You always want under.
Yeah.
Let's try somebody else.
How many 10-sided dice sets do you have? You got a lot.
She used to play champions, right? Champions was
the 10.
No,
just need
champions. D6. What was 10?
Unbelievable!
Wow! Vampire. 94.
Whoa.
Vampire and 7C. Also
7C.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
So well.
Holy crap.
No. You just made a gross face and a noise of disgust and then asked me if I wanted to try it. And my answer is no.
That's better than hey, smell this. Right?
Sometimes that's like a candle, though.
So it's not sweet?
So no. You did not make your sand check.
Yeah, you
correct?
Did not.
No, I did not.
Llama already.
We don't have any mead tonight, Wes.
Yeah, I know. Now
what's
just
your
this
on?
I don't have my glasses on. I don't have a very high dex. You take 5 points. So now you need to make a roll against your intelligence to see if you understand the enormity of what is happening.
This one you...
Now here, after Wes and we have been telling you, you always want to roll low. You actually want to roll over your intelligence for this roll because you don't want to realize what is happening.
Right, because it's called Cthulhu.
Yeah. Hey!
If you realize what's happening, good, it makes it worse.
I didn't realize maybe this isn't so bad that I got low in.
What's your intelligence?
I just can't be right. I was supposed to times it by 5?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's 75 then.
Mother!
Oh no!
You completely understand what's going on and that something is not right here. This is not what God intended
God
for anyone.
God did not give men gills!
Right as you say, God do not give men gills, he backhands you in the face.
Yes,
all right,
of course he
so,
does. I deserve it.
Now you can dodge. It's just, it's not automatic.
Dodge half dex?
Yep. Why don't you give us a dodge roll there?
So I'm trying to do what?
Get under your dodge.
Under half of my dex?
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So 17, I think.
Well, this is gonna be just great.
Llama.
Llama.
Oh! You did it!
That's a 4.
Okay, so you duck. And you've got his knife.
Okay.
Because you tripped and you grabbed onto it, he just turned around and gilled you, and you were like, ah! And but you still have his knife.
Uh-huh.
What do you want to do? You realize you're in the middle of the ocean. There's a horrible storm going on.
It's a horrible storm.
You're around
ship
a
full
bunch
of Vikings.
And a pregnant woman who really wants you to kill her. Choices.
What do you do, Hotshot?
What do you do?
I
take
am being good, so I guess I'm going to have to...
Shoot the hostage?
Shoot the hostage. I guess I'm going to have to call him out as a demon and attack him.
Okay.
Oh,
like any
Jesus.
Sane, normal person would.
No, I won't attack him. You're right. That would be insane.
So I have all
I call him out
I have
as a
all
demon.
The character creation rules right here.
I don't know why this is happening to me. I feel like I've been specifically picked out for murder.
Well, that's just this.
We all feel like that from time to time.
Okay.
No, what?
I take the knife and I hold it on him
here.
As I'm like, demon from hell, stay away. The power of Christ compels you. And then I.
And in his perfect old English, old Norse, he goes, K. So he, the others now have turned around.
Are they all have gills?
Not that
I only
you can
saw
tell.
The one.
Only when they actually open can you see them. So none of them are breathing through their gills if they have them right at this moment.
Mm-hmm.
But he definitely does, and you've irritated him, so they're opening and closing opening and closing. He's not very happy. His pallor is a little off. It's, you know, this like sickly, like greenish, really pale skin. And his eyes are kind of a little bigger than they might should be. Wow, I need to stay away from the southern. They're a little bigger than they should be.
Would you say he's squamous?
He's slightly squalous. And they all start advancing to you, and one of them says something in the language that you don't understand, but you get the gist. Drop the fucking knife. And they're moving towards you.
I say, I'll drop the knife, but I hook it over to the pregnant lady. I'm like, I don't have it anymore. If she does that, then it's not on my head.
So, good. So you throw the knife away, and that's where we're going to stop with your little cutscene.
I think that's probably wise.
Let's see. You guys.
Now do we go to the opening credits?
Opening credits.
That was our total bumper.
Just to explain, last time we played, I messed up your special thing.
Yes.
Explain to chat what I gave him his prophecy. He's supposed to actually roll for it. It's for show.
So what happened last time, though, is I received an image of the albino's men attacking the next morning, right?
Right.
So what's supposed to happen, it's both my pro and my con. This is really hard to do with it. If you activate it as a pro, it's going to be a good prophecy. If you activate it as a con, it's going to be a bad prophecy. So I will roll a d20, I think is what we said, and if... It is, I think it was like a 1 to 14, it's a minor prophecy. If it's a 15 to a 19, it's a major prophecy. And then if it's a 20, it's life or death. And then I will come up with some sort of brief, vaguey rhyming prophecy, and Wes gets to figure out what to do with that.
Right. So next time you guys get that, I won't fuck it up. That's all I can say. All right.
But I might.
Yeah. Okay, so get out your lie dice. Oh, sorry.
Oh, no.
Wait, fuck.
What? Damn it. tell me again. Wait, drink. Go ahead, drink. What does glory do?
Basically, it's my reputation precedes me, either a good way or a bad way. So if it's in a bad way, which I believe it happened last time.
Yeah.
Then, you know, we might get attacked, or I don't know, somebody's a jerk, or it could be any number of things.
Because you murdered their family.
Whatever. Any number of wonderful things Wes can come up with, I'm sure.
Right.
And the pro is just the other way around, like, you know, ooh, I know who you are, free room at this inn tonight, or...
So they're either impressed by you, or not so much.
Yeah.
Or like
any number of ways, but just yeah.
Or like they
positive.
Know her, but they like want to make a name by being the one who takes her down.
Right.
And that's like a... Any of those kinds of things. Yeah. So, let the insanity ensue. Right. I mean.
Right.
It's Cthulhu.
It is.
Call of Cthulhu.
Also, yeah, one thing that I want to mention about these characters are yes, thank you guys for showing up and being our special guest.
Woo!
Ben, I believe, is at PAX South tonight.
That's in Loot Crate.
And. Loot Crate with the
Loot Crate,
which good segue.
Yeah.
You can get Loot Crate through
lootcrate.com/savingthrow,
and then but use
what, promo code saving throw.
Yeah, you get 10% off your first crate if you do that.
That is correct.
But you make sure you use link.
Yes.
And the code. Use all of it.
And what's great about all of that is it leads to new microphones.
We have new microphones now, so probably something else, right?
We can't just keep getting microphones.
New microphones again.
Tons of microphones. I want microphones just hanging everywhere. Yeah. Like the
Flavor Flav.
Like in Seven, where they go into that guy's apartment and he's got all of those things hanging, all of the car things. I want microphones like that.
I can hear Wes so well.
One of those thin Bob Barker microphones.
Right.
Yes.
What were you going to say, Nick?
I was going to say Loot Crate contains all sorts of really, really cool things.
Like this.
If you weren't aware of them before.
This is Loot Crate.
We were going to show off. These came from Loot Crate.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, Ben.
These drinking horns.
Bien. Thanks, Bien.
That's how you say it.
Jeez.
Bien.
Yep. That's how we do.
So that's a push, correct? That one you're typing out right now? It's not a... Reroll?
Okay.
Dum, dum, dum,
dum,
oh. Dum, dum,
dum, dum.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't
want to
be...
Dum, dum, dum.
Okay.
When someone subscribes, they get a free reroll, but for this game, they do.
Yeah.
Ah.
thank you for subscribing. Awesome.
Ooh, yeah. Thank you.
If you like what we do, please subscribe. And all right, keep doing it.
Watch
we
the
just
show?
Did. Anyway. Littlest Finger just subscribed.
Oh,
hey, thank you, Littlest
Finger. And
I toast you,
get
you, but
another
empty.
Push.
Oh, okay. Well, you can do it anyway.
Skull.
Skull!
What are we saying, actually? Because I'm just kind of making
skull.
Did you go through any of the other ones?
Not yet, because they're all.
Are they all combat?
One thing above Littlest Finger.
No, I haven't, because I wanted to do it right before I was waiting.
Okay.
Okay.
Right before everyone's
death. That's scary.
Oh.
Well, it's always
scary. Sounds like I need a drink. Would you?
Oh, well.
Would
you, by the way, their name looks like something from an Aztec god. It's like this long.
Oh, I know who that is.
Yeah. Well, I can say Bob and Mark. I can't do 16 syllables in a row.
So, if you want to keep watching Black Bag, consider changing your Twitch handle to Bob or Mark. Thank you so much.
It makes my life a lot easier. I'm all like BSB.
Kier.
Bien.
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 How'd you learn Spanish? Twitter handles. Okay. So you guys are, everyone's in the town. The Jarl has come out and said, you know, my stepson has told me, my son has told me that there is a invasion coming. It will happen at dawn and we need to get ready. And the town itself is kind of, getting, everybody who's able to fight is getting weapons and preparing. Everybody who is not is getting ready for defense and those kind of things. The ice seems to be melting relatively quickly, a little quicker than you guys are used to seeing it. It's cracking. It seems a bit off. You feel very nervous as you're watching all this. This doesn't seem right. It shouldn't be going as fast. And as you're looking out across the bay, you feel this tug on the back of your shirt, just like that.
Oh, wow. Now I can really inhabit that space. Yes?
Says the guy wearing an eye patch for the past hour.
From 1989's Colors. Okay, so you turn around and it's Inga. She is
Inga.
She is the town's healer, as well as the person who usually the Jarl goes to for conversations about the gods and what the gods want. She's a seer as well. She's pretty old. She's in her later 40s.
Oh man, she's like almost dead.
Yeah, yes. And she goes, I think it's time you and I had a talk. We should go somewhere where we can sit down, and because everybody's running around and stuff. And she goes, we should sit down and have a conversation. She has two eye patches, so you'll have to lead her.
She's always such a one-upper.
You'll have to lead her to life. She's just been at it a little longer than you have.
Fine, Inga.
Okay.
How did she find him?
She's a seer.
Ooh, spookily.
Her special power is sight.
Echolocation.
It's like it's like Daredevil. His superpower is sight.
Yeah.
No, his superpower is enhanced senses across the board. Let's not, you know, downplay. Okay.
Whoa. Like
touched a nerve.
I'm just saying. He's not just a blind guy who can sort of see.
Or what I should
he
say
can
is
see super
no,
rough.
He's a blind lawyer who can sort of see.
He's an avocado.
Okay. Wow.
Cut.
Touched a nerd is what I should have said.
You touched a nerd. Bam! Nerd. Yes. Nice. So you guys go
Elite
to
Inga
your
back to her own house.
Okay. You get there and there's like there's all these herbs and medicines and things that she's collected over the years, and she goes, "Can you tell me about your visions? How do they come to you? Is it painful, or is it, how do you see things?"
It can be painful. It hurts sometimes. Just mostly
bright flashes of some pictures, but mostly words. Okay. Words come to me, but I don't always know what they mean.
Okay. Do you ever see any specific gods, or do you ever feel like a certain god is speaking to you?
No, but how well do I know Inga? Do I know her well at all?
Not really well. You've seen your father talk with her a lot. She's never been cruel to you, but she's been distant.
Would I trust her?
I don't know. That's up to you.
With something, okay.
That's your call.
I'll say no then.
Okay.
No specific gods.
Okay. The reason I'm asking is I know that your visions have come true in the past. And you've had issues and problems with your father because of it. I unfortunately am starting to, you know, get close to the end, and this might be my last battle to be able to enter the next realm. So I plan to take advantage of it. You are the best candidate to take my position. But unfortunately, I don't have any time to train you on much. Do you have any idea about healing medicines and things like that?
Oh, yeah. I do a lot of reading. That's a thing that I learned about, where people write things down and then you read what they wrote.
I've heard of it before.
And in doing so, you steal it's not their knowledge.
I think that reading is the doorway to destruction for the younger generation. I really do. The written word is really...
No one will remember anything.
No one will remember anything.
I know what you mean, yeah.
The oral tradition is how we're supposed to do things,
and
I think that
right. It
makes people get shorter attention spans. I don't approve
of antisocial behavior where they're just reading
my eyes instead of talking to each other. Back into dealing
with
an older person. But
that's your generation, so you'll have to make that decision.
Yeah,
but
I guess, you know, we'll figure it out.
She goes, if something happens to me and I die during these battles that we're about to have, I would like you to take over my duties here.
Oh.
This will do a couple of things for you. Number one, it will take you from a place of scorn from your father and put you in a more higher position, maybe in his mind. I mean, he might still
call
you... Pretty
sure father will still scorn me.
We'll call you terrible things, but the rest of the village will come to you and trust you and need your help. And as the years go on, they will both fear and respect you, and that's...
I mean, I'd settle for people not kicking me as much.
The not kicking is a good perk. So I think that, I think it's you know, something that you would benefit from. So if you are willing to take on the mantle of the town healer and you know, I guess, speaker of the gods, you know.
Oh.
Do you think you can handle that?
Yeah, is the title, like, is that a firm?
Well, I mean, if you want to change the title, it's okay. Yours after I'm gone.
Okay, sure. Yeah, no, thank you, Inga. I would be honored to serve in your stead.
Okay. So, well, we should go back outside and start with the preparations. I'll be doing a lot of healing, helping people with their wounds. And she then turns around and pulls out this ginormous sword out of nowhere. She goes, do you have a blade?